Microsoft has a great feature that is hidden. It is called Filter by Selection. I'm going to show you how to use it. But before I do, we need to discuss the Quick Access Toolbar because that's where I'm going to put this command. Here we go with this data. The Quick Access Toolbar, if I go to Filter and turn on Filter, my Quick Access Toolbar is sitting below the ribbon. I got it there by clicking on the drop-down arrow, and there's above the ribbon and below the ribbon down below. I like it below the ribbon. So if I filter by Meta as an example, you see that this is a few clicks to get Meta to show up here. I had to turn on filters, hit the drop-down, uncheck select all, make sure Meta was checked, and hit OK. A lot of clicks. Here is clear to clear the filter. I want to put clear filter on my Quick Access Toolbar, so I will right-click it and add it to the Quick Access Toolbar, and it sits right here. So now, if I need to clear my filter, doesn't matter if I'm on the Data tab or not, I can select clear. I was able to put clear on there because that's an available command. Well, filter by selection, which I want to show you how to use, is not available by just right-clicking and adding to the Quick Access Toolbar. I'm going to right-click on any command, and I'm going to customize the Quick Access Toolbar. I could go to commands not in the ribbon or all commands. It doesn't matter. I'll just go to commands not in the ribbon. So filter by selection, before you assume that I'm going to jump to the letter F to find it, that is not where you'll find it. If you look for the letter S for selection, it is not there either. It is under auto filter. So here's auto filter, add. Now, I want auto filter. I use this a lot. I'm going to move it up. I'm going to put it next to save, undo, redo, auto filter. So let me just go ahead and put my clear next to my auto filters. Auto filter is the fifth one down. Remember that, and clear is the sixth one down. Click OK. So now I'm going to turn off my filters. Here is filter by selection for text. The bottom of this range, I'm going to just type in Meta. I'm going to click on it, and here is auto filter, and there is Meta right here, and here is my clear next to my auto filter. One more time, let's do the state of Georgia. Lose the Meta. Auto filter, I'm looking at just Georgia in the bottom left. It's telling me how many records I found still. Clear that and then delete that. So before you say, Chris, you could have done this with a right click. True, I could have right clicked on GA, gone to filter, filter by value. That is absolutely true, but now I got to clear the filter. No big deal. So with text, it may not be that big of a time saver. But here is purchases by date in column 8. I want to see purchases greater than 1,000. Now watch this one. We already said it, 1, 2, 3, 4, fifth one over, Alt 5, and I'm done. Because I love keyboard shortcuts, and Alt 6 will clear it because it is the fifth one over and then the sixth one over. So that hopefully should save you some time. One quick one here with the dates. Let's just say less than 7/1/2025. Click it, Alt 5. And those are dates less than July 1, 2025. Clear, Alt 6 if I wanted to, and delete that date. So there is filter by selection. Hope you enjoyed this video. My online training is available for Excel, Copilot, Teams, and OneNote. Have a great day.